Welcome to Innsbruck, an internationally renowned city for winter sports and a famous tourist destination for people who want to enjoy the Austrian Alps. Unfortunately, this year, because of COVID-19, tourism has been put on hold. So we'll show you around how the city is managing life in this coronavirus pandemic and what all you can visit when the tourism opens up again.
It's very cold already. Gotta pack myself in.
It's -3 degrees here. Even though the sun is out, it feels extremely cold.
This is Innsbruck's main pedestrian street, the Maria Theresienstraße. The monument in the middle is called St. Anne's Column. Unfortunately, shops are closed at the moment. But this square is quite a sight in itself.
It is, because we can see the Nordkettin mountains behind. It's very unique for a city center to have such a view of the mountains right from the center. Fortunately for us, there are still many things in Innsbruck which can still be enjoyed from the outside, like this golden roof behind me, or the Otterburg, or the Triumphal Arch. Considering the current situation, the amount of tourists here is absolutely zero. There's literally no one behind me. We were here in the summertime also, and this place was packed with tourists. In fact, this is so empty that my voice is literally echoing here while I'm talking to the camera. There are some public sanitizers that the city of Innsbruck has installed everywhere so people can always remain sanitized and safe. That is a very popular tourist attraction also. If you Google for Innsbruck, that's the image that would come up, the rows of houses behind me. And over there, you can see the Nordkettebahn line going up there. We'll soon go up the very top of that mountain. It's already very, very cold here. I don't want to imagine how cold it must be at the very top of that. The name of this river is Inn, and the word Brücke means bridge. So that's where the name of the city Innsbruck comes from. As you can see here, all the shops are closed. Even the restaurants are closed, only open for takeaway. That means if you want to eat lunch, we take away food and we are not allowed to eat anywhere around the restaurant. This is the Imperial Palace. From the inside, they have very beautiful rooms, but it's closed right now. But you can have a look when you come to visit after the pandemic. Luckily, we'll get a small temporary respite from the cold because the train station is here. The one that takes up to the top of the Nordkette mountain, and inside the train we can be warm until we go to the top and bear the extreme cold.
And of course, Pia will also wear a mask.
In all these mountain trains, cabins and cable cars, this mask is not enough. They have a requirement that you need to be wearing an FFP2 mask. These masks can be purchased at the station itself. There are four different stations for Nordkettenbahn. This Congress station is where we went in. There's an Alpine Zoo station, nice Alpine Zoo at the third station. And right now we're at the fourth last station, Ungerberg station. After this, we have to take the cable car to go at the very top of the mountain. Wow, the whole city of Innsbruck is here. But we are still not at the top. We have to go there. This looks like the edge of the world. Actually, rather dangerous to stand here. Gyms and indoor sports are closed here at the moment, but there's one thing that is open even during these times, which the locals here love to do. It is skiing. As you can see behind me, there's a lot of people skiing here because there's a small ski resort built at the top of this Nordkettin mountain range. However, it's a bit too small for us. We won't do the skiing here. We plan to do it tomorrow in another nearby ski resort, which is far better for beginners and bit bigger in size. If
take the camera, turn it on already, let's run outside, film it and run back inside.
Yeah, that's a good plan because so cool, it's unbearable the cold now. Okay, ready? Yeah. Oh, look who's here. Who's here? Oops, he's gone. Top of Innsbruck. It's crazy. The view from here is crazy. It's full of snowy mountains all around.
After taking the Nordkettebahn, we take two cable cars to reach up to this very top of the mountain. It's called Top of Innsbruck. From here, we can also walk up to that cross mark. When we were here in the summer, we actually went up to that point and we filmed a very nice drone shot. So you can see how that view looks like from up there. I'll insert the drone shot here. But that was in the summer. Right now, we are not sure if we should actually risk going up there because the snow and ice might be very slippery here. As you can see that there is no one here apart from us. This whole place is empty. This looks very dangerous. Down there you can see the whole city of Innsbruck. Up here at this time, basically nothing is open. This point is almost at 3000 meters. It's so high that some people may feel altitude sickness going up this high. But I would say this is a must do if you come to Innsbruck. If you can't bear the cold or the height, just come up here for 15 minutes only because the cable cars keep going down from here every 15 minutes.
Normal masks are not allowed here. You have to wear FFP2 configuration of mask, which is this one. So we had to specially buy it here. There's many different measures they have introduced as a result of Corona. They're asking people for their own safety. Wash your hands regularly, maintain social distance. Even on the ground here in the ski resort, you can see the lines here meant for social distancing. However, we did not really need them because there was hardly a crowd here, as you can see. As it's not open for tourists, so there's not many people coming here to ski. Are you ready to ski?
Yes.
We must keep the windows open for ventilation. These are open good. You must be wearing a mask at all times. We are wearing a mask and pay attention to the instructions. No selfies.
Selfies are allowed.
The snow is literally glittering.
Yeah.
The normal season when the tourists are there before Corona, all these would have been full. We would be sitting here with three more people at least. And now we are going up the cable car. These are our skis. It's rather empty here. In this one gondola, only three people are allowed to be sitting at maximum. And behind you, we can see the whole city, the village down there. Innsbruck is over there. How is that even possible? Is the dog skiing also?
As you can see, it's really, really empty. There's no tourists, only local people.
These kids are doing a better job than me. This Zermattbahn takes us all the way up there, where the path, skiing path number 4 starts from. Normal times, these two would be also open, but right now there's not that many people. That's why only two of these lanes are open, and for social distancing too. Almost everyone here is following the coronavirus regulations very well. Everyone is wearing a mask inside. Outside, you have to cover your face also. But it's nice to see that even here at 2,240 meters, the life is going on as usual.
these restaurants to have lunch in between skiing, but at the moment they're closed, of course, so you gotta bring your own lunch.
It's extremely pleasant here because there's hardly any people skiing. Down there you can see the village Fulkmes. That's the name of this village where the ski resort is located. Beyond that mountain is Innsbruck. So this is the whole map of this Schlick 2000 ski resort. We started skiing from here, which is at 2136 meters, took the path one, which is the easy path, and 1B, we slid here, 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 until we reached this point, which is a middle station, and we took 7 to come back to the lower station, Tal station. But there's so many different possibilities, as you can see, and almost every ski route is open. This is the village of Fulkmes. We came here from Innsbruck by car. It took us 20 minutes. But you can also use the public transport. It takes 40 minutes.